So today we are doing some exploration, but this time it's not about cold really. We are leaving Hämylä behind and heading over to that bush over there. And there's supposed to be like a old reindeer. I don't know what you call this, kaarre. And we are going to check it out, and we have Mr. Majanimi with metal detector, and we will be looking for surface finds because we can't really dig, but we can at least listen, and if it sticks out the ground we can pick it up really. It's about 400 meters, so it's not that far. I've tried to locate it many times, but this time I have GPS, so I can't miss it this time. So we have found it, at least according to the GPS coordinates, and boy, it's overgrown a lot. No wonder I couldn't find it earlier. This is all young birch, and actually I was getting suspicious as we walked towards this place that suddenly the birch got this very thick and very young. So yeah, I think we'll just walk around a little bit and see if we can find anything with our eyes, and then maybe run the metal detector a little bit just to listen if there's anything. I would love to find the perimeter of this place first, and start there would be probably the best place, I think. We are now in the middle. It's about, I'd say, 50 meters across this thing, maybe more. It's not tiny, but there's a lot of mosquitoes, so yeah, I'll cut this and put some more clothes on so I can resist them. So we saw this huge pine tree here, which must be older than this, at least couple, well, over 100 years at least. And I decided to start next to it, and I think there's already some iron here. Maybe old fireplace or something. There could be coal also, I mean embers. According to the meter, they are quite deep. So I think we'll leave this for now, but check the surrounding area. Maybe we hear some more conductive metals. So my enemy is still detecting, and I was walking around and saw this. So there's this clearing, kinda a little bit like a shallow gully. And what do we have? Of course, we have a test hole. I can feel hard rock, I mean ground underneath. So someone has tried gold for here. This looks kinda old, I'd say from 90s. So yeah. Well, kinda does not surprise. So yeah, let's keep detecting. So here we have a birch growing, but it has some issues. Check that out. It's completely gone. This is awesome. Check it out. It's like upside down, and then it has straightened itself up back. That's awesome. I haven't ever seen birds grow like that. Cool. So there's again a signal, and there's a little bit strange pile of stones here. So let's turn a few of these stones around and see what we can see. Okay, they're definitely having something. Very quite unstable signal, but I hope this is not some sort of old trash pile hidden or something. But it's getting quite nice signal actually. 46, 40, 22. So this shouldn't be iron at least. Let's see if I can move that. Yep. I am getting a bit suspicious because these stones are here like piled. Maybe someone has hidden something here. Okay, that's new, 32. Yeah, there's definitely something here. I think that's not the stone. Okay, that stone is hot. Okay, so maybe we have a hot rock. Let's see what kind of stone this is. It's kind of heavy, so maybe iron. Let's try to break it so we can see inside it. It's a nice anvil. I think that's iron. You can clearly see those blue stripes. So that's probably what's making the detector beep. Yeah, I think that's what it was. Sounded good though. So we are in the middle of this kind of small clearing. I don't know, maybe an old campsite or something. Looks like it. There's lots of stone rings and, well, not rings, but piles of stone. This might be natural or not, but here we have a next contender. It's giving high signals, but then again, as we just earlier saw, that maybe it's just a hot stone. But yeah, let's keep it up and see what it is. Actually, that doesn't look too promising. There's a huge stone right there, so maybe it's just that stone. Yeah, I think it's just a stone. What? Yeah, that's it. So it's again one of those similar kind of stones. Well, let's keep looking. So we were just crashing through that huge thicket there, and my enemy spotted this bottle here. It has still the metal ring on the neck. I actually assume that there is a cork is also somewhere here. But unfortunately the bottle that we checked the bottom, and it doesn't have any label, or it just says K12. Don't know what that means. Would be nice to find the cork and see maybe if that has the year in it, so we know from what era is that. Also the question now is, what's that bottle doing right here in the middle of this thing? So I think we are kinda in the right place. So my enemy thought that we maybe smart take the bottle with us, so he fetched the bottle and put the cork back on, and it fits, I think, somehow there, and it seems to be from that bottle. Who knows for sure, but at least we can try to date it now. So we are taking that with us. And meanwhile, I was doing that. Maybe you can take the camera. Check this out. So I was thinking that since we found the cork right here and the can somewhere a few meters back that way, and what do we have here? Another can. Also, there seems to be a lot of trash around this area. I can hear stuff. So that's a can, definitely. There. It's not coming out.
That's a smaller can.
Again, not a chance to get dead out of that. So let's toss it next to the other one. And let's hear what else we have. So they have stopped here to eat at some point. Was it gold miners or was the they were just
eat and drink?
Eat and drink here, or maybe they were the reindeers who had the fencing here once. That's the error. Eh? So I was going again with this path and found something here, but couldn't pinpoint it properly with the proper director, so I finally can test this thing and it seems to be working. So we have something right there. Let's try to nail it out. What it is. Hopefully nothing sharp. I should have something like a bad knife or something to dig it. So I can, if it's like a broken neck of bottle, I won't cut myself. It's right there. Ah, I can feel something. There. A button. Yeah, that's button. Thin brass button. You can see the holes for the thread. There's some sort of rimming that's coming off. It's actually copper, I think. Yeah. So someone has lost his button. That's actually quite interesting find. That's an actual real relic. Unfortunately, there's no. Nothing like it's coming to be in the pieces, so thin. I hope I didn't cut myself. Should wear those cutbury gloves for this kind of stuff. But yeah, that's it. A button. I think I'll stash that one somewhere. So again, on this same path. You can barely see the place where we found the button, and I have something else maybe. Rest of the jacket. I think there's multiple signals here. And they are giving quite a nice signal. So let's try and see if we can find them. Well, are they too small for this? No. Color? Okay. What is that? It's not that. Okay, now it flew somewhere. What is this? It's so small. It's not that one. No. Still deeper. A little bit scared digging this with hand. No? What? It's that. So, what is that? Piece of gold? No, this is a piece of foil or something. Thin. Very tiny. That's it. It's very sharp also. I guess there are more. It's something, maybe actually pieces of third cork. I guess. I heard another one somewhere. But this is not good picking it up. Let's turn with the detector once more. I believe there are more. Oh, this is very sharp. I should use gloves. So yeah, there's many more. I was almost excited to see that it's cold, but because we are in cold country, so it's not impossible. I wonder what this is. It looks like tin of from can or maybe cork. Actually, there is text also. So it's probably cork. Maybe I can straighten it up a little bit. No, it's too brittle. It breaks down. But you can see barely some sort of text. So it's probably from cork. Huh. Interesting. So there was this big birch here. We were directly around it because my theory is that people like to hang around next to big trees, and maybe and it seems to be working to some extent at least. So yeah, well, we'll keep going and see what we find. So we were making a second pass along this path, and the detector suddenly started giving OL, so that means of course overload, and which of course means there's huge piece of iron. And I kick some around until I started using pinpointer, and then I noticed that sticking out. To me that looks like a tip of a big axe. So let's pull it out. Okay, so this is big one. Yeah, that's it. That's actually a pretty good one. I can use that. So there has been... Is that a... No, that's not metal. Is there any... So this must be from 50s. I guess they have been testing here. Been doing... Because there's this gallery here, so they might have been doing some test holes. And actually, this is pretty nice design. I like this. Very handy. Good sharp edge. This is almost brand new, look. It hasn't been used at all. I think it has dropped unused almost. I can't see any hits. So it's basically brand new, except of course it has rusted. We'll be taking this. Very nice. There's also something else. And now I have tool to dig with. So let's have a look at what else we have. There's of course probably a lot of rust here, but... Okay, so that dealt that one. Although object this sized makes a huge noise around it, so maybe it was just this. And it seems to be like that. So it was just this. Yep. Let's see if they have dropped anything else here. Maybe they have dig and dig holes and then frustrated and tossed it away. And the wooden handle has rotted away long time ago. Yeah, it's quiet now. But cool, very cool find actually. There's no markings. Or is there? There is something. Hard to make. I think there's some sort of labeling on that. There's usually around this spot here, there's maker's markings, but they have rusted away if they have ever been there. But yeah, let's keep on cracking. We don't have much road to go anymore. So we are back, and pretty much this was the only interesting like big thing we found. And yeah, it was kind of hot trip, mainly because of this goddamn mosquito. But yeah, we are back at Hämyland. Next we have lunch, and then just rest of the day slack off and do nothing. So see you next time.